today, when we walk out of here and God's been glorified, then we've done our job. No matter if it goes good or bad, sometimes I preach a good sermon, they say, and sometimes it's a bad sermon, so you can't get a home run every time. But I know these kids and youth have worked so hard, and I've seen some of it, and it's going to be great. But we want to just glorify God in everything that we've done and said tonight. So we're going to get started. I'm going to go ahead and open up with a word of prayer, and then we'll get started. Father, we thank you for this day, for watching over us, the safety. Lord, as I thought about earlier, Lord, just watching those kids out there, Lord, we know it's not realistic, but it's the image, it's the idea, it's the memories that those children will have. Lord, as we think about that night, Lord, the night that you were born, the day that you came, that you left heaven and you came to this earth, clothed in flesh, and you came that we might have eternal life. Lord, that's what we celebrate tonight, the fact that you came. The good news is you're coming back. We want everybody to know that as well. So God, I pray that you'll be with everything, with the sound system, the videos, and all the different things that's going on. But Lord, we'll be quick to give you the glory and the honor for it all. This we ask in Jesus' name.
Number 199, Oh Come All Ye Faithful.
Once upon a time, in a Galilee far, far away,
an angel came to Mary.
She was doing laundry outside.
Yeah.
Oh, she was hanging up clothes.
An angel popped up and she got scared.
She threw the clothes because she got scared. And the angel said, "You're going to have a baby."
Baby of boys. I forgot the word. I forgot all the words.
You're going to have a baby. And his name is going to be Jesus.
And I was like, "I'm not going to have a baby. I'm not even married."
Then the angel came to Joseph.
So what did the angel tell Joseph?
That he was going to have a baby.
That he was going to have a baby?
And there it was.
They went to Bethlehem on a camel.
Like, I'm a donkey, look. And like, how could I, like, I was about to say, like, right here to right here. Like, how would Mary fit right here, and Joseph would fit right here, and the baby would, like, sit, like, right baby here. They'll be, like, school of stable. Like, it was like the baby's in the carriage, see? The carriage, carriage, and the baby's there, so Mary and Joseph, see? How could they be on that donkey just so small?
Mary said, "This donkey's fast."
They were looking for a place to stay.
The innkeeper said there was no room, literally no room,
and the baby couldn't stay.
The only place to stay in Bethlehem was a stable.
Then he just pointed the way and they followed.
He put them in a hay ranch. He put them on all horses and cattle and pigs and sheep and goats.
The shepherds were taking care of the sheep.
Then they saw angels.
The angel said a new baby is getting born.
And they were singing.
Can you sing me the song that the angels sang?
Nope. It was in the background. So you can hear it.
Can you sing a little bit of it for me?
Baby of boy, the king of the world.
Hallelujah!
Was that good?
Then the shepherd said, "I think we should go there and meet them."
Then they went to where Jesus was, and then the wise men heard about it.
They were just chilling, and then
they saw a star, and they're like, "Hey, let's follow this star," and it led them to Jesus.
They brought him gifts.
They brought him Frankenstein. Gold. The other one.
There was gold.
Gold, silver.
And myrrh.
Myrrh.
He's gonna be our best friend.
He's gonna change the world.
We're thankful for Jesus' birth.
Sweet silver bells all seem to say, throw care. cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the poor.
Ding, dong, ding, dong. Ding, dong, ding, dong, that is the song that joy will ring. All caroling, one seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, raising the sound of hill and dale, telling the tale. Songs of good cheer, Christmas is here. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Merry, merry, merry Christmas. On, on they send, on without end, air, joyful tone to every home. Hark how the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to sing. Throw cares away, ding dong, ding dong, that is their song. With joyful ring, all caroling, one seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they come. Songs of good cheer, Christmas is here. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. 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 Hark how the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing a cheer to young and old, meek and the poor. Hark how the bells, sweet silver bells, Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Oh, how they pound, raising the sound, oh, and the dust, telling the tale, gaily they ring, while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here, merry, 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 merry Christmas. Merry, merry, merry Christmas. Merry, merry, merry Christmas. Merry, merry, merry Christmas.
Cry. did Jay leave it? I don't know where she went. Long ago in a village small, a young girl was working hard to push away the cares of life and give to God her own. When on a special night an angel came and told her she would bear the Son of God. For her life was made for a glorious plan, and she would never be the same. She cried, "How can this be? How could a perfect God have such a perfect plan for someone like me? So unworthy am I to be chosen for this task, but with your strength and with your grace, surrender, Lord, is my heart's cry."
Away the pain he felt watching Mary walk alone. When on a special night an angel came and told him Mary's child was the Son of God. Joseph ran to Mary with fears all gone. His life would never be the same. Right.
How can this be? How could a perfect God have such a perfect plan for someone like me? So unworthy am I to be chosen for this task, but with your strength and with your grace, surrender, Lord, is my heart's cry.
Then God
knocks at my door and tells me he has made a plan to use my life in a special way I've never dreamed before. I cried, "How can this be? How could a perfect God have such a perfect plan for someone like me? So unworthy am I to be chosen for this task, but with your strength and with your grace, surrender, Lord, my heart's cry. Surrender, Lord.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels try? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak. The praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great I.
come just for the rich or just for the know-it-alls or the wannabes and all that. The Lord Jesus was sent upon this earth, and the angels, when they came and told the little shepherds, or maybe they weren't all little, but told the shepherds, here he comes. And he says there, behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you, every single one of us here tonight, the Lord Jesus came Amen. For you.
Amen.
And God wants you to know that. God left his place in heaven, but he stayed there. But he left his place in heaven. He sent his son, clothed with humanity. And he came and he was born as baby Jesus. That's what we celebrate. But baby Jesus grew up. Amen. He grew up. The Bible says that he lived that sinless life. And for 33 years he was on this earth. And so he began to work his ministry and all the preaching. And we read all about that in the Gospels and all the things that went on there. The Bible says that he did gave his life. Nobody took it. Nobody had to take it, for he offered it. The Bible says something more after he was crucified, he rose from the dead. The Bible says he's coming back.
Amen.
And that's our promise, that he's coming back. And this is, I saw some signs. If it wasn't for Christmas, there'd be no Easter. If there wasn't no Easter, we wouldn't really celebrate Christmas. But I'll tell you, we celebrate tonight. Head bowed and eyes closed. I'm just going to ask you a simple question tonight. I'm not going to embarrass you. I would never want to embarrass anyone. But I want to just ask you a simple question. The Lord came tonight. If he came to you, he said, why should I let you into my heaven? It's my heaven. Why should I let you in? What would your answer be? If your answer is anything but because Jesus Christ died for me and I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. If your answer is anything but that, say, but God, I've done all of this, I've done all that, none of that matters. Not when it comes to salvation. I've accepted you as my Lord and Savior. That's the answer. I want to ask you, while heads are bowed and eyes closed, if there's one here tonight, I won't embarrass you, I promise you that. If there's one here tonight to say, I don't know if the Lord came to me tonight, if I would have absolute assurance of my salvation. Would there be one? Nobody's looking around. You can just lift the finger, lift the hand. And the reason I'm asking is because I want to pray. Thank you. Thank you so much. See, the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave. What did he give? He gave his one and only Son. His only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish. No. But have everlasting. Let's pray this prayer. Lord Jesus. this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Now I'll tell you something. We do invite everybody to stay. We've got a great fellowship across the street, the fellowship hall. I love to be around God's people, don't you? Some of you I know, well, I didn't bring nothing. Well, you can have my cracker. If I have to give up my cracker, you can have my cracker. But I ain't never seen this run out of you. I mean, you know, God always provides. But we do invite you to stay and fellowship because we need to love on each other. Because tonight we're celebrating. I want you to give a hand for everybody that worked so hard. We do that today. All the youth leaders and the kids leaders working on Wednesday night, week after week after week. And for the choir, boy, y'all just wouldn't know how much trouble they give either. Boy, I tell you, she got a tough job. I thank everybody for working so hard because it was all to celebrate the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
All right. I'd like to thank my elves that helped me. You'd like to thank your elves.
Elves.
You had some elves helping you. Would you like to recognize your elves?
As elves.
As elves. Okay. They know, we know who they are. And I tell you, from the horses to spread the straw. I seen somebody out there raking the straw up at some point in time. It's just good to do something for the Lord.
Amen.
You can't out